Hey everybody, it's me, Gregor Manarino. How are you today? It is Saturday, July 23rd, 2016. Welcome to a new segment of The Week in Review with a look ahead. So let's talk about this week here with regard to the markets. Still remaining in some type of a topping phase. I've gone over this pretty much the whole week. I've shown you charts, I've shown you graphs. There's no conviction behind this, and I want you to really focus on that, because if you were to turn on the financial channels, even today, if you turn on the regular news channels, they're talking about the markets, you know, they're sitting there cheerleading about this market, but where's the conviction? That's what I want to know. They want you to assume that people are rushing into this market, institutions are buying up everything possible. It's just not true. I'm sorry. There is no volume here. You have to look at many metrics when you're trying to put together the puzzle of these markets. It's very complicated, but a huge one is volume. So when you see a market making high after high, or right now we're trading at about the flat line, trying to push through resistance on no volume or almost no volume here, that says a lot to me, people. And next week is going to be tremendous. We got a lot more earnings coming in, and we got the Federal Reserve. I believe that's going to be the highlight of the entire week. There's a two-day meeting beginning on Tuesday. Wednesday is going to be some kind of a policy announcement. They're not going to raise rates. They can't raise rates, despite the narrative that we remain in some type of a miraculous recovery. According to President Obama, everything is just fine. Unemployment is at historic lows and all this other nonsense. It's garbage. It's absolute garbage and it's absolute lies. You know what to look at, people. If you want to take anything away from how to gauge whether an economy is moving in the right direction, you only need to look at two things, and two things only. Number one is the velocity of money. I cover this all the time. That is the rate at which cash is moving through an economy. If cash is not moving through the economy, we're not generating any tax income from it. So that alone should tell you that we have a problem. But we are at historic lows with regard to money velocity. The other metric, which, again, you will never hear Obama or Hillary or anyone who has an agenda trying to push that there's an economic recovery talk about, is the labor force participation rate. Cover this all the time. This metric has to be moving higher for an economy to recover. We are at historic lows once again. Both of those major metrics. So, and the Federal Reserve gets it. That's why they can never raise rates. Well, one of the reasons. The other reason is that yield curve that I cover all the time. The Federal Reserve will not allow the short end of that curve to come up. They won't allow it. The reason for that is we're already seeing the yield curve flatten. I have been saying for a while now that because the Federal Reserve has that short end of the yield curve pinned down by holding the federal funds rate at near zero, not allowing it to move, the long end of that curve is coming down. And that's exactly what we've been seeing. We see the yield curve flattening. The Federal Reserve will not raise interest rates because it would nudge up the short end. We get a completely flat yield curve. The last two times we saw this happen, we had the dot-com bubble crash. We had the 2008 bubble crash as well. In the same exact scenario, flattening curve, rising markets, something has to give. And this week is going to be a big one, I think. I still believe we are going to remain in this extreme greed phase with regard to the fear and greed indicator that just happens to be Warren Buffett's favorite indicator, by the way. So, you know, we may still end up in this topping phase here. Who knows? Again, the issue of no volume means that all you need is a slight trigger to cause the market to roll over. I still believe that the monetary metals are in a bottoming phase, like I've covered this week. The bond market also in some type of a bottoming phase. It's a perfect storm. I talked about, in fact, I did a video with that exact title, The Perfect Storm. No doubt about it. There's three things are coming together exactly at the same time. Something else is going on. Let me just touch on that before I let you go. We're moving into August. This is notoriously a bad month for the Dow. So that may also play into this. So maybe there's four things in play here. Anyway, we'll see how it plays out. Again, this week, let's watch the Federal Reserve. Let's hear what comes out of the mouth of these people, so we can laugh about it. I promise to talk about it during the week. It's going to be interesting. Anyway, with that said, I hope you have enjoyed this segment of the Week in Review with a look ahead. Let's see how it plays out. I'll see you Monday. I have to look at many metrics when you're trying to put together the puzzle of these markets. It's very complicated, but a huge one is volume. So when you see a market making high after high, or right now we're trading at about the flat line, trying to push through resistance on no volume or almost no volume here, that says a lot to me, people. And next week is going to be tremendous. We got a lot more earnings coming in, and we got the Federal Reserve. I believe that's going to be the highlight of the entire week. There's a two-day meeting beginning on Tuesday. Wednesday is going to be some kind of a policy announcement. They're not going to raise rates. They can't raise rates, despite the narrative that we remain in some type of a miraculous recovery, according to President Obama. Everything is just fine. Unemployment is at historic lows, and all this other nonsense. It's garbage. It's absolute for an economy to recover. We are at historic lows once again, both of those major metrics. So, and the Federal Reserve gets it. That's why they can never raise rates. Well, one of the reasons, the other reason is that yield curve that I cover all the time. The Federal Reserve will not allow the short end of that curve to come up. They won't allow it. The reason for that is we're already seeing the yield curve flatten. I have been saying for a while now that because the Federal Reserve has that short end of the yield curve pinned down by holding the federal funds rate at near zero, not allowing it to move, the long end of that curve is coming down. And that's exactly what we've been seeing. We see the yield curve flattening. The Federal Reserve will not raise interest rates because it would nudge up the short end. We get a completely flat yield curve. The last two times we saw this happen, we had the dot-com bubble crash. We had the 2008 bubble crash as well. In the same exact scenario, flattening curve, rising market. Hey everybody, it's me, Greg Arena, Hawaii today. It is Saturday, July 23rd, 2016. Welcome to a new segment of the Week in Review with a look ahead. So let's talk about this week here with regard to the markets. Still remaining in some type of a topping phase. I've gone over this pretty much the whole week. I've shown you charts, I've shown you graphs. There's no conviction behind this, and I want you to really focus on that, because if you were to turn on the financial channels, even today, if you turn on the regular news channels, they're talking about the markets. They're sitting there cheerleading about this market, but where's the conviction? That's what I want to know. They want you to assume that people are rushing into this market, institutions are buying up everything possible. It's just not true. I'm sorry. There is no volume here. Something has to give. And this week is going to be a big one, I think. I still believe we are going to remain in this extreme greed phase with regard to the fear and greed indicator. That just happens to be Warren Buffett's favorite indicator, by the way. We may still end up in this topping phase here. Who knows? Again, the issue of no volume means that all you need is a slight trigger to cause the market to roll over. I still believe that the monetary metals are in a bottoming phase, like I've covered this week. The bond market also in some type of a bottoming phase. It's a perfect storm. I talked about, in fact, I did a video with that exact title, The Perfect Storm. No doubt about it. There's three things are coming together exactly at the same time. Something else is going on. Let me just touch on that before I let you go. Absolute garbage, and it's absolute lies. You know what to look at, people. If you want to take anything away from how to gauge whether an economy is moving in the right direction, you only need to look at two things, and two things only. Number one is the velocity of money. I cover this all the time. That is the rate at which cash is moving through an economy. If cash is not moving through the economy, we're not generating any tax income from it. So that alone should tell you that we have a problem. Well, we are at historic lows with regard to money velocity. The other metric, which again, you will never hear Obama or Hillary or anyone who has an agenda of trying to push that there's an economic recovery talk about, is the labor force participation rate. Cover this all the time. This metric has to be moving higher. Hey everybody, it's me, Greg Arena, Hawaii today. It is Saturday, July 23rd, 2016. Welcome to a new segment of The Week in Review with a look ahead. So let's talk about this week here with regard to the markets. Still remaining in some type of a topping phase. I've gone over this pretty much the whole week. I've shown you charts, I've shown you graphs. There's no conviction behind this, and I want you to really focus on that. Wednesday is going to be some kind of a policy announcement. They're not going to raise rates. They can't raise rates despite the narrative that we remain in some type of a miraculous recovery, according to President Obama. Everything is just fine. Unemployment is at historic lows, and all this other nonsense. It's garbage. It's absolute garbage and it's absolute lies. You know what to look at, people. If you want to take anything away from how to gauge whether an economy is moving in the right direction, you only need to look at two things, and two things only. Number one is the velocity of money. I cover this all the time. That is the rate at which cash is moving through an economy. If cash is not moving through the economy, we're not generating any tax income from it. So that alone should tell you that we have a problem. Well, we are at historic lows with regard to money velocity. The other metric, which again, you will never hear, because if you were to turn on the financial channels, even today, if you turn on the regular news channels, they're talking about the markets. They're sitting there cheerleading about this market, but where's the conviction? That's what I want to know. They want you to assume that people are rushing into this market, institutions are buying up everything possible. And it's just not true. I'm sorry. There is no volume here. You have to look at many metrics when you're trying to put together the puzzle of these markets. It's very complicated, but a huge one is volume. So when you see a market making high after high, or right now we're treading at about the flat line, trying to push through resistance on no volume or almost no volume here, that says a lot to me, people. And next week is going to be tremendous. We got a lot more earnings coming in, and we got the Federal Reserve. I believe that's going to be the highlight of the entire week. There's a two-day meeting beginning on Tuesday.